ఋషిభ్యో బ్రహ్మ విద్యా సంప్రదాయ కర్తృభ్యో వంశ ఋషిభ్యో మహద్భ్యో నమో గురుభ్యః సర్వోపప్లవరహిత ప్రజ్ఞాన గణ ప్రత్యగర్థో బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి సోహమస్మి బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి. ఓం ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్రవేత్రైకపాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుఃఖే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ది వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర ది ఆల్ మైటీ bestow all kinds of prosperity, good health, wealth and eternal happiness to you and your entire family members and friends. Let us begin Bhagavad Gita, 3rd chapter, verse number 19. Shri Bhagavan Vacha Tasmad Asaktas Satatam Karyam Karma Samachara Asakto Hyacharan Karma పరమాప్నోతి పురుషః. అర్జున బిగన్ దిస్ చాప్టర్ విత్ ద క్వశ్చన్, వై యు ఆర్ పుషింగ్ మీ ఇన్ ద డేంజరస్ కర్మ? బికాస్ వెన్ యూ లర్న్ కర్మ, ఇట్ హ్యాస్ గాట్ ఇట్స్ ఓన్ ఫ్రూట్. పీపుల్ విల్ రియలైజ్ దట్ నాట్ టు గో టు కర్మ, బెటర్ టు అవాయిడ్ ద కర్మ. బట్ ఇన్ ద బిగినింగ్ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్ Krishna told, don't imagine, never ever be endowed with akarma, inaction, because the tendency of our mind and body always wants to take rest. That urge, longing for rest is dangerous. So we can give the rest for the body if it is necessary. If it goes more than that, you have to avoid. It will create the drowsiness, laziness. That laziness will bring disease and mentally you will also will be blocked. Therefore, karma is the weapon. You have to perform karma, no option it. Therefore, Krishna, he began teaching Arjuna, you cannot avoid because everything is nothing but karma. Arjuna wanted to quit the karma and take the sannyasa. Though his mind was attracted towards sannyasa, but he was not prepared himself. That's a completely different path. We have to understand the world is the creation. Creation means it's a manifestation. That manifestation has got its own process. Krishna has answered, why I am saying like that? Because everything is karma. Even dropping is also a karma. That activity, the action to drop, to think, to drop, that itself karma. If you want to get away from the karma, you cannot do it. When you do it or think about that, that itself becomes karma. That karma will produce phala. It means what? We cannot do it. But if we understand it, the nature of karma, then we can use the karma to gain the quality and capacity to become away from karma, to withdraw karma. This is like, you know, you might have noticed a game in which all the ropes are connected towards a ceiling and everyone will be connected with the rope and they will play dandiya. They don't look up, they will just they will follow the steps which was taught for them. Then after half of the game, for the half of the game, so it will create knot. And after half of the game, then the remaining game, they don't look up, they will follow the steps, that knot will be removed. In the same way, already because of the ignorance, we have accumulated lots of knots. That's what karma bandha, that has to be removed by using the karma alone. That is the only one way to get away from the karma, to be liberated from the karma. That's what Krishna has nicely explained. Karma means it has got its own nature. You should have a proper bhavana. You should know how to convert karma into yajna. That also yajna means what? It's a refined karma. 100% sure the fruit will take place. Then, in order to avoid the fruit, in order to avoid fruit means what? Again, you should not get into the karma. Therefore, we have to have yajna bhavana. That by adapting the yajna bhavana, you can conquer the karma. That's what the process. He was telling that if you follow that process, finally you will learn the process of samsara pravritti chakra, the cycling of the universe. You cannot touch anywhere to change it. You have to go according to that. Automatically the karma will leave you. The karma will drop itself. Means what? The karma will remain, the body will be endowed with the function, the mind also will be endowed with the thoughts, and even you may have the desire, all those things won't bind you. That's what he has given in the last two verses. Though he works, but he is self-contented, not focused outside, that is the prayojana. So that level, it will take its own place. Till that time you have to work. Therefore, he says, therefore Arjuna, tasmat karyam karma samachara. Karyam means is to be done. The work that which is prescribed by Veda, especially for you being Kshatriya and you being as the Grahastashrama, being a king, you have to protect your dharma. That is the duty. Karyam karma. Karyam means to be done. You have to follow the karma, but with a different attitude, the attitude which was introduced by Krishna in the form of yajna bhavana. That yajna bhavana means what? Selflessness. Practicing selflessness even in the yajna, even in the karma, whatever that you do. First, we have to convert. We should know how to convert karma into yajna. That becomes the tapas. You have to listen again and again, again and again, what he taught for the past, how many, 7 or 8 verses. It's very important. In the second chapter itself, he began, yoga thakur karmani sangam tektva dhananjaya siddhya siddhyo samo bhutva samatvam yoga uchyate dure nahyavaram karma buddhi yoga dhananjaya buddhau sharanam anvichha kripana phalahetavaha. Don't run behind the fruit of karma, then you will become kripanaha, poor person. All people running behind the karma, karma phala, for name and fame and money and everything, they are like shadow. You cannot reach the shadow. When you run, the shadow also will run. You cannot gain anything. Therefore, drop that attitude and stand in the yoga. Adapt yoga. Yoga staha, being in yoga. Yoga means what? Buddhi yoga. That buddhi yoga to be supported with the knowledge which has been given elaborately in this chapter. Yajna bhavana. See, when you have the yajna bhavana, when you have the understanding which was given, you are the author of karma, means you are nothing but Brahman. You are also a kind of a part of cosmos. You need not to get anything, you need not to give anything, just you remain in you. So till that state you have to work. So that working with a different attitude, that's what he said, asaktaha. The karma, the action which is performed with yajna bhavana means with a detached manner, definitely they will take you to the target. The target is ultimate target. For that, you need not to go to forest. You need not to renounce anything. You need not to sit for tapas for long years. Just you follow your own duty, but with different attitude, you will definitely get it. That's what Krishna's analysis about karma. And also he gives evidence for that in the next verse. Let us read it. Karma naiva hitam siddhim asthita janakadayaha loka sangraham evapi sampashyan kartum arhasi. One person asked me, because when I thought first time 10 years ago, this concept of karma, the cycling, because the human being is because of food, the food is because of rain, rain is because of yajna, yajna is because of karma, karma is because of Veda, Veda exists in the Brahman, we are nothing but Brahman. If we have this understanding, he asks, when I chant, when I do japa, and when I do worship, who produces karma phala? Ishvara produces karma phala, that is sure. But you have to understand it, Ishvara is where? Ishvara is everywhere. In you also there is a consciousness which is in the form of I is nothing but Ishvara. When you chant something, when you chant the Rudra or Chamaka or Purusha Sukta or Shri Sukta, Om Hiranyavarnam Haranim Suvarnara Jatasrajam Chandram Hiranmayim Lakshmin Jata Vedo Maavaha Tam Maavaha Jata Vedo Lakshmi Manapagaminim. So when you chant, your consciousness is nothing but Lakshmi. Sagastra Sirusha Purushaha Sagastra Akshat Sagastra Pata Sabhumim Vishvato Vritva Atyatishthaddashangulam Purusha Evedagum Sarvam Yad Bhotan Yad Chabhavyam Udamrut Atvasyeshanaha. So when you chant Purusha Sukta, when you chant Shri Sukta, so you become that deity, you can identify that deity. It means what? When you do Parayana, you are the person who is producing punya. You don't think that that Lord is sitting in Vaikuntha and the Saraswati is also sitting and pressing his leg. They will produce. They are here, here, here. I say again and again, here. Your Ishvara is here. When you go to see Tirumala Tirupati, Balaji, when you look at the Balaji, you just close your eyes, isn't it? My dear, Ishvara is felt here. Ishvara is experienced here. That's what Gita says. You are the author. It means what? You need not to have a doubt whether God is or not. God is there in the form of you. You cannot deny that I am not. Never you can deny yourself, because yourself is evident by the self. Nobody can deny you because it's experienced only by you. He says the example, this all this janakadayaha, let me read once again. Karma naiva hi samsiddhim asthitaha janakadayaha. Janaka etc. He was a very famous king, the father of Sita. And not only him, Janakadayaha, Ashwapati, Ikshvahu, and Ambarish, so many rishis were there. They didn't renounce their life. They didn't take sannyasa. Being a king, Janaka used to go regularly for the classes. And he was a dedicated student, but he didn't quit the Rajya, kingdom. He was completely following all the duties, and by the time when he started studying, he never lived his life. He remained as a king. After studying also, he continued as the king before knowledge and after knowledge. After knowledge, whatever the karma he has done, it became loka sangraha. The word is magic. Karma becomes magic. Now the sun, river, mountain and all the stars, all of them are endowed with karma, but in the form of loka sangraha, selfless karma. They don't expect anything. Even trees are endowed with loka sangraha. Now when you realize this, you will become like a sun, like a moon, like a planets, like the nature. You will become one with the nature. That is what a glorious understanding we should have now. You have to be like Janaka. Those people were Kshatriyas. They were ruling the country at the same time. They also understood the truth. And they used the same karma as the weapon. Karma naiva hi samsiddhim. So one should not conclude that karma will give moksha. Karma won't give moksha. When you change the karma, when you convert karma into as an ajna, tattoo nishkamya karma bhavanaya. So when you bring that nishkamya bhava, selflessness as the sacrificing ajna karya, then it is the magic will take place. This is how those people also attain the completeness. Therefore, you need not quit at any time, not only for Arjuna, for all of us. You need not to quit. Then how many sannyasis are there? I would like to become sannyasi. Your wish will be fulfilled if you are qualified. Guru will come in front of you. I tell you, because in my experience, I have experienced a lot. Being humble to my gurus, I am confident enough to say that when you are qualified, guru will appear in front of you, or you will be taken in front of your guru. That's what we have to begin by now. The same work, even brushing mouth can be converted into an ajna. Taking snana can be converted into an ajna. So when you become a devotee of Balaji, when you see everywhere, everything is nothing but Balaji, your body also becomes Venkateswara Balaji. And somebody had also had the questions. I saw somebody told that. So who is superior, Lord Krishna or Lord Mahavishnu? They are both none other than one God. Mahavishnu is the tattva. That tattva has become like a teacher. That teacher is Krishna. Now, Krishna is Acharya, who is none other than Mahavishnu. No difference in it. Okay. Now he continues, Loka Sangrahameva Api Sampashyan Kartumarhasi. Realize the magical the karma which will take place in you when you perform with the understanding. Because the normal people will follow the great people. That is the society. The society, you think the society, all people are with clarity with their karma. Everybody, if they convert their karma into yajna, you think the welfare of the society, you think the quality of the society, how it would be. So highly standard society, that's what our India in ancient time. Therefore we had lots of temples, lots of dharmakarya. It was, even Kohinoor, diamond, we were prosperous people, we are. And we used to, recently this Padmanabha temple, so how much gold and diamonds we got, because we offer everything to Ishvara. We used to do loka sangraha. Our dharma is to make loka sangraha. Everybody should perform loka sangraha, not karma. Karma, when you perform, you are a slave. When you convert into an ajna, when you perform a karma and convert into an ajna, you become yajamana, you become author. you are liberated. You can enjoy the Jivan Muktavastha. That is the society. That society which we need. Next words. Yadyadacharati shrethaha tatta deveta rojanaha sayat pramanam kudute lokastadanuvartate. And Arjuna, you have also responsibility. You are the captain of the ship. You are the warrior who is example for all other warriors in his contemplation. That exemplary personality should not make mistake, should not commit mistake. Don't make a wrong decision, because people follow, the normal people follow their leaders, their personalities, their model. You are the model of so many lakhs, crores of people. Therefore, be careful. Yadyata acharati shrethaha tatat itara janaha acharati. So that's what, you know, those people are itara janaha acharanti. Saha yat pramanam kurte. What you value, people also value for it. If you value Vedas, if you value yajna bhavana, definitely people will also follow. But if you run away, there will be chaos. They will get confused. Therefore, be a responsible person and act responsible way. That's what he says. Then he also says about himself, you take my example. You know, you may not, you might have not understood about me. I was with this understanding for a long time, but you were not noticed because you were not up to that level. For example, for me, I am still doing whatever to be done. I didn't quit after the knowledge realized. Name parthasti kartavyam tresho lokesho kinchana nana vaptam avaptavyam vartayeva cha karmani. I don't have any duty, okay, but still I work. I don't have any duty not here, bhuhu, bhavaha, swaha, even in the three lokas. I don't have any duty to perform them. Then I have nothing to achieve because I am self-content person, means realized one. So he didn't use that word, but he says that whatever the karma comes from Krishna, they are nothing but loka sangraha. This has to be understood when you read Bhagavata, when you read Ramayana. So Rama was endowed with this knowledge. Therefore, whatever the karma, it was loka sangraha. You need to have a special eye to judge their activities. And many people, they debate, you know, why Krishna did all kinds of cunning job. They were not cunning job. He was trying to establish. If you have a vision, if you have the proper perception, you can understand about their karma, their quality of the karma. That we will continue in the next verse, because this is very important. When you understand about your karma, your life will begin magic. That's what I use the word. Loka sangraha means it's a magic. After receiving the knowledge, I mean after the realization, whatever you do, you cannot go wrong. You cannot go wrong. If you got a proper guru, if you received a proper teaching, if you had a proper analysis, proper inquiry between the lesson and the worldly experience. You have to match and you have to analyze your experience and lesson. That is known as mananam, the path mananam, where you just become doubtless person. Then finally nididhyasanam, it is known as shravana manana nididhyasanam. This three steps of the teaching, if it takes place, definitely you can become a magic. That magical personality is the personality of every Indian citizen. We are glorious people. We have to realize this, all the secrets which are like a king among all other secrets. We will continue in the next episode tomorrow. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.